Hello, my name is Justine and I'm a mental health counselor. Welcome to the series of videos on how to heal from disordered eating. Those videos are also for you if you struggle with emotional eating, if you're looking for the way to numb your feelings with food, or you have a hard time losing weight, or perhaps you may also look for a different way to connect to your body, to read signals from it, and to build a relationship to your body. This is the second of 5 videos in which I will provide you with information and tools how to attend what's underneath those challenges that you might have experienced with food. And as you step on the path of healing from disordered eating, it will have a ripple effect on every area of your life, on your relationships, career, parenting, and definitely your health. These videos are for you, but also for someone that you know about, or maybe for your children who might be struggling in this area. I'll be posting a new video each week, along with accurate exercises. So I'm looking forward to have you joining me in this experience. If you have not seen the previous video, please go back and see it, because in that video, I explain why issues such in disordered eating take place and how to use that mechanism in a constructive way. I also explain why do we have different conversations in our heads about food and body image and how to approach them in a constructive way. In the previous video, I also provide you with exercises how to explore that issue in a deeper way. In this video, I'll talk about how to develop awareness of our feelings and our needs and how to meet them. Very rarely we have been taught how to approach our feelings and our needs in a constructive way. So naturally, we have developed unhealthy strategies how to deal with them, and food can be one of them. Feelings are a natural part of life. Not knowing how to process them might have caused you to try to manage them with food, either numbing feelings by overeating or snacking every time you feel an emotion, or by not eating enough, physically hurting the body. And that physical hurt has become an antidote for your emotional pain. We might be using food to soothe ourselves when we experience fear, or when we experience a loss or a setback in our career, or also if we haven't processed the pain we have experienced in the past, any past traumas, difficulties in our relationship, separations. In our culture, we are rarely taught how to approach our feelings and how to give ourselves what we need. We are not taught that we have to attend our emotions, but on the contrary, we are being pushed to quickly get over them, that they are unattractive and certainly inconvenient. Our culture does not teach us how to take care of ourselves and give ourselves what we need in the very moment. In order to heal from a disordered eating, we need to learn how to attend our feelings, acknowledge them, give them space, give them voice, embrace them, so they no longer are affecting our behaviors in an unhealthy way. And at the same time, as we get curious about our feelings, they will also communicate to us how to give ourselves what we need in the very moment. As we heal the emotional wounds, we will not only heal the disorder, but we also will be able to gain wisdom from those wounds. Each wound carries a feeling, a jewel that is yet to be discovered. Feeling the pain of a loss can be an incredibly rich experience. Being with sadness might teach you compassion. Consciously embracing feelings of anger might lead you to create healthy boundaries and give you strength to speak up your truth and follow your dreams. Sometimes those feelings can be deep and painful. You may even think like, oh, I was doing great, and then suddenly I feel like crap. This is the healing process. Sometimes you might be feeling tired and heavy and feel like that pain will never end. So I just want to make it conscious that this is the healing journey of the eating disorder. So you can even imagine that the healing process looks like that. Imagine having a splinter in your skin. Somebody has put that under your skin, and every time someone presses on it, it hurts, right? Because it has been placed there in the past. And now, as you step on the healing process, you open a wound, which is painful, you take out the splinter, which might also be very uncomfortable, but then with time, the wound is going to heal. And then anybody in the future can be pressing and pressing and pressing, and it's not going to be painful anymore. So you can imagine that in those areas, you feel that you have sensitivities. Those are the places where you probably have been wounded in the past. As you step on the path of healing and slowly begin to release stagnant emotions from your body, pulling out those splinters, you might start to feel more settled inside. Your anxiety might decline, and you might start to feel lighter and more solid in your body. You will feel more energized and confident. And your need to manage your emotions with food or other substances will decrease. Journaling can be a beautiful way to process emotions. So I'd like you to take a notebook and write down the answers to the following questions. Do you remember a situation, could be a recent situation, when a strong feeling or emotion come up? Could be around food or your body image. Please write it down and also describe how did it feel physically in your body. To take this exercise a little deeper, you may think about a time before you were 11. Think about those moments which were very difficult for you and answer the questions below. Emotions need to be named. Sadness, grief, anger, love, even passion. So as you name them, write them down. And then they have to be experienced as a felt sense. So describe how does it feel to have them in the body? What is the physical sensation of each emotion? And then observe how they change. Thanks for watching the video, and I hope you found it helpful, and I'll see you in a week.